Qualcomm's top-of-the-line mobile chip is receiving a new name. But the recently revealed Snapdragon 8 Elite delivers more than just surface modifications, as it's based on a 3-nanometer technology, contains a new CPU, and boasts lots of brain processing to handle new on-device AI functions. The Snapdragon 8 Elite should power the forthcoming Samsung Galaxy S25 series and all of the greatest Android phones for the future year. Qualcomm showed off the Snapdragon 8 Elite on October 21, boasting off its many advancements during the chipmaker's annual Snapdragon Summit. And these are things you're going to want to know about if you're interested in switching to a new Android phone, and how it might rival Apple's iPhone 16 lineup. Here's what we know about the Snapdragon 8 Elite based on Qualcomm's preview and what it potentially means for phones powered by the new CPU. We won't have to wait long to see phones that utilize this new system on chip. Qualcomm identified 9 phone makers committed to featuring the Snapdragon 8 Elite and claimed those businesses are poised to launch devices powered by the Snapdragon 8 Elite in the coming weeks. Notably, Samsung and OnePlus are listed on the list of firms vowing to use the Snapdragon 8 Elite along with Asus, Xiaomi, Honor, Oppo, and a number of other device makers who predominantly do business in China. While no specific models have been stated, those kind of announcements are normally left to phone makers. It's additional proof that we'll see the Snapdragon 8 Elite in at least some of Samsung's Galaxy S25 versions, as well as the OnePlus 13. The OnePlus 13 is likely to appear in China initially around October 31, however, the release date is not yet announced. Similarly, we're anticipating Samsung to conduct its Galaxy S25 launch event in January, at which point we'll learn if the Snapdragon 8 Elite powers just the Galaxy S25 Ultra worldwide, or whether it's featured in additional S25 variants outside of North America. We already know some of the phones that will have the Snapdragon 8 Elite. Asus plans to reveal their ROG Phone 9 with a new chipset in November, while the Honor Magic 7 will also use Qualcomm's latest chipset. The latter phone debuts on October 30, and it will introduce the Honor AI agent that uses text and voice prompts to perform actions on your behalf, such as placing to-go orders or book tickets. Xiaomi's Adam Zheng spoke at the Snapdragon Summit in Hawaii to reveal that the Xiaomi 15 series would be first smartphone powered by Snapdragon 8 Elite globally. But it's unclear if globally means the US, where Xiaomi generally does not release phones. Like Apple's A18 Silicon, the Snapdragon 8 Elite will be constructed using a 3M technology, an upgrade over the 4M process that the current Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 employs. The smaller the process, the closer transistors are packed together, enhancing both performance and power efficiency. Considering the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 wasn't exactly a shrinking violet in any respect, that bodes well for the performance and battery life of Snapdragon 8 Elite powered devices. Qualcomm has made another update to its chipset. As had been announced previously to today's announcement, the Creo CPU utilized on earlier Snapdragon 8 chipsets is giving way to a variant of Qualcomm's Orion CPU optimized for mobile. Orion is the CPU featured in Qualcomm's Snapdragon X Elite Silicon for connected computing, and Qualcomm says that adopting a second-generation version of that chip will optimize surfing, gaming, and other activities on mobile devices. The Orion CPU utilized for the Snapdragon 8 Elite brings a whole new architecture with 2 prime cores running at 4.3 GHz and 6 performance cores, which are designed to tackle intense activities while maximizing battery efficiency. Qualcomm is eliminating efficiency cores from this version of Orion, continuing a trend of employing fewer efficiency cores in its CPUs. The microarchitecture also introduces a data prefetcher, which Qualcomm says can increase speed. It includes an instant wake feature that essentially removes the wake-up sequence so that a call can get right to the business at hand. In terms of performance, Qualcomm expects to expect 45% gains in both single-core and multi-core tasks over the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3, with web browsing speeding up by 62%. At the same time, CPU power efficiency should improve by 44% with the Orion CPU. Qualcomm provided some benchmarks for the Snapdragon 8 Elite, in which a reference smartphone powered by the chipset averaged single and multi-core scores of 3,221 and 10,426 on Geekbench 6. We'll have an opportunity to conduct some tests on the Snapdragon 8 Elite later this week, so we can verify those statistics. But if they prove accurate, they'll easily top the 2,300 single-core and 7,249 multi-core numbers we got when testing the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3-powered Galaxy S24 Ultra. The single-core score of the Snapdragon 8 Elite would be on par with the iPhone 16 Pro Max's 3,386 result. But the multi-core figure would best the iPhone 16 Pro Max score by 26%. Get ready for the iPhone versus Android battle to reignite. In a particularly eye-opening moment during the Snapdragon 8 Elite's launch, Qualcomm CEO noted that the mobile chip delivers 62% faster performance than Intel's just-released Lunar Lake chipset for laptops. The mobile chipset also consumes less power than its laptop-based rival, according to Qualcomm's figures. The Orion CPU isn't the only portion of the system-on-chip receiving improvements. The Snapdragon 8 Elite's Adreno GPU is receiving a boost too, with a new sliced architecture that dedicates memory for each slice, which should result in faster and smoother gameplay that lasts longer thanks to battery life improvements. In fact, Qualcomm is predicting that gaming sessions can last 2.5 hours longer on Snapdragon 8 Elite device because of the GPU improvements. The sliced architecture should also permit more cinematic and detailed landscapes, continuing to establish mobile devices as a viable gaming platform. Recent Adreno GPUs in Qualcomm's mobile chipsets have concentrated on ray tracing functionality, and that continues with the Snapdragon 8 Elite. Qualcomm predicts a 35% improvement in ray tracing. Meanwhile, the Snapdragon 8 Elite provides mobile compatibility for Unreal Engine 5.3 with Nanite, enhancing the possibility of more immersive 3D worlds for games on mobile. Qualcomm also optimized support for Unreal Chaos Physics Engine with its GPU. All, Qualcomm estimates a 40% improvement in performance from the Snapdragon 8 Elite's Adreno GPU compared to last year's silicon. Power efficiency should improve by 40% for the GPU. According to Qualcomm's benchmarks, the Snapdragon 8 Elite-powered reference handset earned an average score of 159 frames per second on the 3D Mark Wildlife Unlimited test, which would be a 28% improvement over what we saw from the Galaxy S24 Ultra. It further extends the gap with iPhones, as the A18 Pro-powered iPhone 16 Pro Max only hit 107.5 FEPS on that same test. Every premium phone worth its price tag these days wants to give AI-powered capabilities, especially if they can be handled on the device itself. The Snapdragon 8 Elite is making its pitch to satisfy this demand by incorporating multimodal generative AI applications for support on-device experiences. And it aims to achieve this while protecting your privacy and minimizing latency. That requires a novel design for the AI engine on the Snapdragon silicon, aided by the Orion CPU, which not on-device handles latency-critical AI operations, but launches AI workloads. As a Qualcomm executive puts it, Orion is handling the heavy lifting while other portions of the Mural engine take on AI-specific duties. According to Qualcomm, the end product should enhance the neural processing unit's speed by 45% over last year's iteration. Additionally, Qualcomm added colors to both the scalar and vector accelerators to suit the needs of generative AI. Significantly, the Snapdragon 8 Elite allows a higher capacity of tokens, meaning customers can supply the AI assistant on board their phone with a larger files to process. And the Qualcomm Sensing Hub has been updated to better grasp your personal context for more personalized output for your questions. In demos during the Snapdragon Summit keynote, the firm demonstrated off a scenario where you could snap an image of the bill at a restaurant and ask a digital assistant on your phone to split the cost. In another example of multimodal smarts, the assistant was able to identify the flowers used in a lei solely from a camera image. Qualcomm's comments regarding the AI capabilities of Android phones powered by Snapdragon comes as Apple is preparing to distribute its Apple Intelligence features to select iPhones and other devices via a software update. Apple is trying to play catch-up with businesses like Google and Samsung. A recent report indicated that Apple is 2 years behind the leaders in AI, and the enhancements coming to the Snapdragon 8 Elite figures to keep Android devices ahead of the iPhone far into next year. It's also worth taking note of the modifications added to the image signal processor on board the Snapdragon 8 Elite. Qualcomm enhanced the hexagon direct link between the new AI ASP and neural engine to deliver AI advancements to photographs. Those features include employing AI to expand the borders of a photo beyond its frame, greater quality and clarity for photographs, and increased AI segmentation to recognize distinct items and enhance them. Specific to that final capability, Qualcomm's technology can partition an image into more than 250 layers, optimizing each one for more natural skin tones, sharper-looking skies, and more. In addition to AI-enhanced focusing, auto-white balance and auto-exposure, pixel throughput has grown by 35% to 4.3 gigapixel per second. That allows the Snapdragon 8 Elite to record from 348 megapixels, sensors concurrently at 30 FPS. The AI ISP provides magic editor-style eraser capabilities to video, in which you may turn to the video object eraser to eliminate undesired items from your video clip, with the editing taking place totally on device instead of having you send your material to the cloud for processing. Additionally, the improved chipset will handle low-light video capture at 4K at 60 FPS resolutions. There are a few other Snapdragon 8 Elite characteristics worth taking note of. The new processor contains Qualcomm's Snapdragon X85G modem RF system for enhanced connectivity, and it integrates Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and UWB to help with geographic proximity. There's Wi-Fi 7 support through Qualcomm's FastConnect 7900 mobile connectivity system. Qualcomm's Snapdragon Summit continues through Wednesday, October 23, with the promise of more demos highlighting the Snapdragon 8 Elite's capabilities. We'll update this Snapdragon 8 Elite reference guide with further details as they become available. That's it for today's video. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more tech news and updates.